Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm watching Blaise Tundu and she's sharing a story of a lady come from a Kenya in Saudi Arabia and her madam's son impregnated her. And let me remember my story, guys. This story, I decided not to share it, but I want to share that maybe some of our housemates, okay, those in Saudi Arabia, we just learn a lesson from it. I will never and ever advise my enemy, my friend, my enemy, and my family member to just go to Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia is good. If you are not lucky, you meet somebody that will just maltreat you, and you will be say, had I known. And they say, had I known, it's always at last, okay? So guys, today I want to share this story to you guys. I was there one beautiful morning. I wake up and I said, alhamdulillah, I just want to start my work. And at that moment, I was in the kitchen, okay, just washing my dishes. And I saw somebody standing on my back. And I said, who is this? Let me just look. When I turned my face, do you guys see what I have saw? My madam's son holding a gun. It's not even a knife or it's not even something, holding a gun. And I know that that gun is working perfectly. By that time, I'm going through depression. I will not lie, you guys know if you go to Saudi Arabia as a new, you go through depression. And at that time, I just always 7 months, okay? I reached 7 months there, and I don't understand the Arab. I don't understand. And you guys know that they don't, Arab, some of them don't understand the English too. So I saw him holding a gun, like, on my back. And what came to my mind at that moment, I was just surprised, and I confused. I don't know what he wants. And you know that he cannot just communicate to me. He cannot speak the English, and that's what I mean. So I cannot just speak the Arab. I don't understand. So what he do is he just showing me signs. He do signs to me, sign. I don't even understand what this guy is want. I don't understand. And I was just looking at him, and he said he will shoot me. And I said, what? For what reason? For what reason are you going to shoot me? And at that time, I told you guys that I just going through a depression. So I said, okay, go ahead and shoot me. As for me, I just said to him, I said, shoot me. You guys will say, are you crazy? Is the gun is really working? One of his brother is a police, okay? One of her brother is a police. So when he closed for work, he replaced the gun in her mom place, because they don't want to send the gun to her place because he have a small children. Maybe they will use it to just playing and something may happen, okay? So he replaced the gun with her mom place and he go. So her brother gun that he will just pull at me. And I understand what he wants, okay? Understand what he wants. He do the sign to me, and later I understand what he wants. And I said to him, I said, shoot me, I'm there. You know God. I just asked a question. I said, you know God. You know Allah. If you know Allah, shoot me. And the day of judgment, okay? Allah will judge us. So shoot me. As for me, I'm tired. I just told her that I'm tired because I'm working, I'm doing this, I'm going through depression and all these things. And you too, you want to just add your problem to me. If you know that you are rich, why don't you get married? So at that time, I told him to shoot me. Okay, guys, I told him to shoot me. I don't afraid of gun. I told him, I don't afraid. I'm an African lady. I told him that I'm an African. If I want these things, I will not come to Saudi Arabia to work as a housemaid. Africa, we have so many prostitutes. But I decided not to do this job. That's why I left home, Africa, to here, to work. And he don't understand. So me too, he do this, I do this, and I show my son. And later he say, when I say he shoot me, he was just looking at me. I was confused. He too confused because he think that at least the gun there, I'll accept it. And I told him to shoot me. guys, let me share my experience to you guys. Saudi Arabia is like, if you're working there and your boss is harassing you, her son is harassing you, and you accept it, the moment you accept it, that's the final. Every day, if you know that maybe me is a gun that he pulled on me, okay, and maybe I afraid the gun and I accept it, every day he put that gun on me, every day. So I know it. I know it, and I say shoot me. I don't afraid of that, because I come from I'm a contract house, and if you shoot me, at least they will just find some information about me. So I don't say anything, and I just told her to shoot me, and she was just standing there, don't know what to do. And he said, hey, you don't afraid of gun, whatever, he will pull a knife. And guys, what happened next? He left the gun and pulled the knife. If you guys want me to continue, please like this video, comment, I should continue, and I will continue, because Saudi Arabia, we go through a lot, and some of us don't even want to talk. So today, when I saw Blessed Tondo sharing the story of a lady, came from Kenya, her madam's son impregnated her, he don't know what to do. Guys, and I was just, when I listened to the story, I was just laughing. At the same time, I was just like, bring back to memories when I'm in Saudi Arabia. It's not easy at all. Working in Saudi Arabia, you have to, like, spiritual guide, and you too, you have to protect yourself physically and be prayerful and all of these things. Saudi Arabia, I would never advise anybody to go to Saudi Arabia. Even my enemy, I would never advise him to go. Because if the person went there and things are not going well for him or her, you put the blame on you. So guys, I will see you in the next part. Like this video and comment. And I will share this story, last part, with you guys. So I will see you guys in my next video. Bye. Masalama.